You're probably familiar with this kind of software architecture. A user interface calls into a business logic layer, which in turn calls into data access. The UI knows that the business logic exists and it depends on it. The logic knows of the data access layer too. The data layer, however, doesn't know that the other layers exist. This is the traditional N-tier or layered architecture. But what if we invert the dependency between the logic and the data access? The logic still makes calls into the data access layer, but it doesn't know what it's calling. But how? Well, the logic layer defines an interface that it expects to be implemented in the data access layer. You're probably used to seeing your iRepository interface living alongside the repository implementation, but simply moving this interface means we invert the direction of dependency between these layers. The interface is called a port. The data access layer knows how to implement that port by using an adapter. This architecture became known as ports and adapters, but it was originally called the hexagonal architecture. The idea was that you could have many adapters around your application core. This means that the core logic has no dependencies. It's pure code with no networks and no reference to the outside world, which makes it very easy to write tests for. On the left, we can add adapters for other presentations, such as an API or a command line interface. These are called the primary or the driving adapters because they drive or they make calls into the core. On the right-hand side, we have the adapters for the infrastructure, such as for sending emails or using a message queue. These are called the secondary or the driven adapters because of the inverted control. It's the core that drives them. The Onion architecture divides the application core into other layers, with the dependencies always pointing inwards. The adapters form an outer layer for all of the infrastructure, sometimes split into two to separate the presentation layer for the driving or primary adapters from the back-end infrastructure. At the center, with no dependencies, is the domain model, the core business objects. It's common to follow domain-driven design, or DDD, practices for this layer. The other layers in between may vary. Typically just outside our domain models are our domain services, which can contain logic that spans across multiple domain models, and our data abstractions, such as an iRepository interface and maybe an iUnit of Work interface. But only the abstractions, these are ports that are expected to be implemented by adapters in the infrastructure layer. Outside of this are the service classes, or the commands and queries if you're following CQRS patterns. And this is where we can orchestrate interactions between domain objects, such as by handling domain events. Clean architecture extends this a little further, bringing in concepts from other architectures to form a single actionable idea. It gives more meaningful names to these layers. The center is for enterprise-wide business rules, the entities, the core domain objects. These are the least likely to change. There is no distinction for domain services in clean architecture, but there's no strict rule on the number of layers either, so we can keep a separate layer if we want to. The application layer is for application-specific business rules, described as use cases. Here we see some ports for the service interfaces and command and query models, and the term interactors for the implementations. The infrastructure layer contains interface adapters. These are described in more abstract terms. Controllers, like in MVC, handle the requests from an API or a UI. Presenters, which convert the response of a use case interactor to a view model. And then gateways, which convert data from external services, the most common example being the repositories. Clean architecture also defines a layer outside of these for the frameworks and the drivers. The database, the UI, the web, devices, and external interfaces. There won't be much code in here, it's just the glue that wires everything together.